All protocol observed. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what to say. I must first thank the main speaker. I think you've heard exactly what it is all about. This gentleman who spoke, he is a gentleman who was during the President Lula's era, and he was involved, and he's one of the gentlemen who made life change in Brazil. I really feel so humbled when I see so many people in this hall, and the majority of them young people. This humbles me because the target I am looking at is young people. When I went to Brazil and got motivated by what they did, I just said, I don't have to reinvent the wheel. I just have to copy what the Brazilians did for their country and introduce it to South Africa and see as to whether we cannot make change and life better. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a problem. 21 years in our new dispensation, we have the majority of our youngsters unemployed. We were just given a wake-up call a month ago when the students revolted against the tariffs that have been plucked into the universities. People coming from where we come from, people of my color, how on earth could they ever afford it, the kind of increase in educational fees when we were never given an opportunity of participating in the economy so that we can amass wealth like our white counterparts did? Where on earth could these people have afforded that? I really feel the action that was taken by the students was a worthwhile action. But thanks God now that the government is looking into this very, very seriously, and hopefully, as they are looking so seriously in this, I would like them to come up with a situation where they can say all black children from sub A to matric, they must get free education. I say so because we would not want to see any child not going to school because his parents are not working, because his parents are not employed, and because his parents are poor. We must have a change. We must look into educating our children very, very, very seriously. Having said that, The most important thing now that we must look into is unemployment. You know, empty stomach knows no law. These children, they get educated, they get educated, and they go and basket some and get no employment. And what do they do thereafter? They are attracted to do, get into things that they did not intend getting into. And the result is that some of them land in jail and so on. This kind of a situation cannot be allowed. 21 years in our new dispensation, we still have the majority of our people very poor. I think we must declare war against poverty, unemployment, and inequality. I think South Africans, if we can join hands, we can do it. I know that we can do it. We demonstrated this when we did, when we hosted the 2010 Games. The world did not believe that South Africa can do it. We actually did it, and we did it better. As a result, we were, I think, voted number two in hosting games. This initiative is not an individual initiative. I want to invite government, industry, and all other people to join hands with us to see as to whether we cannot bring change into this country. And I believe we can do it. South Africans are a great nation. We know this. We've demonstrated it, and we can make it. I want to appeal to industry in particular. The reason the Brazilians succeeded, they did not do it. President Lula did not do it alone. He involved industry. Every trainee that was in their institution got employed, and some of them got into business in their own right. They say 99%, if not 100% of them, they were all employed or got into business in their own right. Therefore, if I would like to continue to make this appeal to industry and government that we must join hands. 2016, I'm going onto a road show. You know, I'm a young man of 95 years old. And thanks God that the Lord has given me the kind of life He has given me. And I'm appealing to the Lord again to give me another bonus of 10 years. So that I must see this happening in 10 years' time. We must not have any unemployment in this country, and we must have, not have, the majority of our people poor in this country. I would like to see this happening. The Brazilians did it, and there's no reason. We being only 50 million people, that we cannot do it. The Brazilians are a big nation. They are 200 million people, but in 10 years' time, they brought 40% unemployment to 5%. And they upgraded 25 million people to a middle-class standard. And as a result of that, there were no longer any Brazilian who goes to bed having not had a meal. If you go to Brazil, you can actually feel it and see it, how happy the people are. Everybody has got something at the back of his pocket, and they're all very happy. And this is the kind of situation I want to see in this country. We have the resources. We are not a poor country. We are the main gate of Africa. Why can't we take a lead and declare education from standard, from sub A to metric, free education? I think this must happen. And once this can happen, we shall have attended to poverty, unemployment, and inequality. There is no doubt about that. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to invite all of you next year when I get into the roadshow to join hands with me. I know that amongst you there are very brilliant young ladies and gentlemen who can actually take it on their shoulders and see that whatever we want to do happens and we make the success of this dream. This is a legacy that I would like to leave for South Africa. And I really believe if it does happen, we shall have created a South Africa we all can dream of. Having said this, I don't know as to whether there are aspirant young people who are entrepreneurs here. I wanted to give you a little bit of my background, but if I can start talking about my journey is a very long one. It's a 95-year journey. I can talk until the cows come home. I don't want to bore you on that one, but I just want to tell you this, that it was very, very difficult during apartheid time when I applied for a license, for a clothing license in Soweto. I was told by the powers that be that, listen, young man, you have no right whatsoever to think of getting into business in this area. If you want to get into business, you must go where your fathers are born, and this is where you might find opportunities. We were told that we came into the urban areas to sell our labor, not to get into business. By the way, you must all understand that during that time, We were all not South Africans. We were foreigners in our own fatherland or motherland. We belonged to quasi little places called homelands. Doesn't matter where you came from. But as long as you're wearing my color, you were a foreigner. It's only after 1994 when Dr. President Mandela became the first president of this country that we discovered our dignity. It was only then that we really became South Africans. Hence, we are having the kind of quality life we are having now. Those days, we belonged to some quasi little place called homelands. I don't want to, if I can start talking about apartheid, about what happened to us during apartheid, I think we would talk until tomorrow. I would like to thank you very, very much for coming to listen to us this evening. Gaspedi, but ke majumai, matomo mayo. Gaspedi, ke matomo mayo. Next year, we will invite you again, and when we invite you, I think we will be much bigger than this, and I think we will have more white people than what I can see here. I see quite a number of our white friends here, but I think next year half the hall will be having quite a number of white people also coming to listen to us. Thank you very, very much indeed for coming to listen to us, and believe me, you did not have a wasted evening. We are meaning it when we say we would like to make change in this country. Main concern, poverty, unemployment, and inequality. I don't want to see a situation where a hungry man would wake up and say, enough is enough, we are going to take it. That would be a disaster. It's in our hands. This is what Dr. Mandela always said. It is in our hands. We can make a change. It is in our hands. We can overnight bring a change into this country. Thank you very, very much indeed.
University of Johannesburg. Rethink. Reinvent.